has had someone that they were either extremely in love with or just so happy with in the relationship? And in fact, when you're in love with someone or have just extreme happiness with someone, your brain actually has extreme amounts of dopamine and oxytocin, and which are the feelings of pleasure and happiness. But everyone has been in this relationship, but something has caused that to end, whether it's been fighting, cheating, or just someone's unhappy and abruptly ended the relationship. When these things happen, the brain releases multiple stress hormones like cortisol and epinephrine. So if everyone experiences these heartbreaks, why is it just so hard to talk about? And why do we truly even know what heartbreak is? So to understand what heartbreak really is, we need to know why we react to these things and what it is. So what causes the broken hearts and the heartbreak would be traumatic emotional stress and trauma. And it's actually even possible to die from these events. So the common name for this syndrome, I guess, would be broken heart syndrome. And the informal medical name is stress-induced cardiomyopathy. And the formal medical name would be Takubot's cardiomyopathy. And what happens is it causes sudden intense chest pain and shortness of breath. So part of your heart is actually enlarging and your body is actually struggling to pump blood through. And when it enlarges, the heartstrings in your heart stretch out. And since they're so fragile, they actually tend to break, which is technically how you can die from this. So it's actually really similar to a heart attack as well, with like all your symptoms, but there are no clogged arteries. So an overabundance of cortisol is rushing through your body, which are the stress hormones as mentioned before. And too much blood is going to your brain, which is causing muscle stiffness, which can also cause like pulsing sensation in your chest, which is why people think it's like a heart attack, because they feel these things. And there's other short-term effects such as arrhythmias, which is irregular heartbeats, and cardiogenic shock, but these things need to be treated immediately or else they can be fatal. And if it's not fatal and you survive, quote unquote, prolonged, it can cause severe muscle failure in your heart, and your body could go into rigor mortis, which usually when you die, your body will go into rigor mortis, which is when your muscles will stiffen and become very rigid, so it's very hard for you to move. So when people go through these traumatic experiences, they feel as if their body is physically hurting, and your brain is telling your body you've been physically hurt, and you really haven't been, but your brain and your heart are telling you that you have been, so your body goes into this state. So what really causes this would be death of a loved one, divorce, breakup, physical separation, betrayal, and romantic rejection. And women are actually more likely to suffer from stress-induced cardiomyopathy because they're more emotionally dependent and visibly emotionally dependent on a significant other than men are. There are actually more established ties between mental illness and stress-induced cardiomyopathy. And physical symptoms can be treated. Like, you can treat like an enlarged heart. You can obviously deal with that. But you can't exactly deal with mental illness on a physical scale with medicine per se. And most people, when you go through a breakup, will just be like, oh, just take time, like everything will be okay. But those things don't always work for everybody. And like, yes, time will help, but there are other ways to kind of speed up the process per se and leave you feeling better about yourself. So when you break up with someone or someone breaks up with you, usually people feel broken, lost, and kind of worthless. So a way to fix that and make yourself feel better about yourself is listing your strengths and achievements and realizing how well you're doing in your life with or without this person. So you could say, hey, I made that team last week, so hey, that's good for me. Oh, I've been eating healthy for a week, like, oh, like that's good for me. You're building up yourself by doing things that you're rewarding yourself with the little things, essentially. And another way to do this is helping people that are in the same boat as you, someone who else is going through a tough time or another heartbreak or the loss of a loved one. And you can build off each other and grow off each other and work with each other to go through this hard time. Helping people that aren't in the same situation as you also can help you, because you're boosting your morale and realizing you're helping other people. Even though you can't make your own day, you're making someone else's day and benefiting others. Jim Valvano also said, if you laugh, you think, and you cry, that's a full day. And what he says in this is that these things all are benefiting your day, and by doing all of these things, you're boosting your morale like laughing does. You're making yourself happy. And if you're thinking, you're getting your mind working and you're realizing how you can benefit other people or how you can benefit yourself. And crying actually removes biochemical products in your emotional tears. That's why everyone, when you cry, you feel so good afterwards. That's why you feel a giant relief lifted off your chest, because you're releasing these stress hormones and these biochemical products in your body, and you just feel relieved afterwards. So physical exercise also is another way to relieve yourself of this stress, because it causes an increase of serotonin and norepinephrine, and it's stimulating brain chemicals, which are fostering nerve cells to grow in your brain, which essentially is making you smarter, I guess, but it's also working on relieving these stress hormones that have overtaken your body when you go through these traumatic events. And like I just listed all of the mental things that we kind of go through with all these like chemicals and things that are going through our body, we also react to breakups and traumatic events with physical actions. So when we cut our hair or we change our looks or we decide we want to try something crazy or pick up a new hobby just because someone ended things with or we lost someone that we loved, it's because breakups leave us insecure and think that we're unacceptable to society and think that we need to change ourselves completely. Whereas when this person left us, they were the ones who made us think that we were doing this, that we needed to change. So we change ourselves to fit society and make ourselves stand out when really we don't need to. We're the same person we were before. We're just stronger after going through this. What I really want everyone to take from this talk is to see how many ways there are to fix a broken heart per se, as opposed to just taking time, and to get rid of the taboo and the stigma behind a broken heart, and how to take care of yourself and support others properly that are going through this. Thank you.